the motivation behind this project? What do you want to introduce about the conference? Our friend is to create a new sentence with different words, but can make a sentence in either the most output and simple sentence, but be in the same language. And perfect can be used as a tool for data application, especially for natural language processing, field for the low resource languages. And however, there has not been much work concerning about developing a paraphrase system for multilingual system, multilingual sentence. Therefore, our goal here is first we want to build a paraphrase system that can firstly able to, on the setting of a multilingual, it can create real-life paraphrasing, it can understand the entities and the relationship in the input in order to preserve this information in the output, and we want to create and evaluate on the first multilingual multi-domain paraphrasing evaluation system. Last but not least, we aim to develop a paraphrase as one of the key point for data adaptation tool. So, in order to do so, we can have scope to two problems. The first one is about the paraphrase generation. Here, we only focus on the standard level of paraphrasing, instead of paragraph. And the next one is a multilingual paraphrasing. However, we require that every single word inside the input must be the same language. So, after we conduct the project, go through the experiment, we come up with some contributions here. Firstly, we have applied the parameter physics by tuning on the multilingual language model. We have integrated the adversarial training into the unsupervised learning. We have gathered and extract to be the first multilingual, multi-domain paraphrasing evaluation data set, and also consolidate the most recent paraphrase evaluation objectives to the single REM system. So, next one is about the background of the way it works. Firstly, this is the taxonomy for some of the common approaches for paraphrasing system. You can see here three common techniques. First one is the supervised, one of the most common is the round-trip translation here. This can first translate the sentence into another language, then translate it back. Also called a back translation in order to serve the same semantic sentence. And we have the unsupervised training, use the with the reconstruction objectives to reconstruct the corrupted input. We also have transfer learning, which visualize some of the language model like T2, Mark, or T5 in order to generate the paraphrase. However, here we aim at the multilingual settings. Therefore, we have to investigate the multilingual language model system. And far is the secret signal denoting of the corner. We have HGD is the auto-aggressive GDP line model on 61 languages, which are 61 languages, with two checkpoints, 1.3 and 13 billion parameters. And we also figure out, because the multilingualisms allow test model on the cross-lingual transfer learning, this means that the model can be test applicable on the unseen languages during the fine-tuning study. So, however, the multilingual large language model too deep to be fully fine-tuning, especially given the computational resources that we have. Therefore, we need to investigate into the use of parameter efficient fine-tuning. Some of the notable work around these approaches, the first one is adapter at the trainable parameter to each layer of transformer. Transforming this part, we have also have lower adaptation, which needs to replace a key in value matrix inside the separation with two smaller matrix, so-called matrix decomposition, where the crop tuning with add trainable parameter directly compared to input embedding. And next, my friend Tim will continue with the adversarial training.
So I will continue with the adversarial training. So the adversarial training is a very famous technique to develop a neural network, and it is as a way to enhance the security of a machine learning system. For example, we can use it in the self-driving car safety or the copyright detection. And there are many works to improve the adversarial training, and here are some work and that we use in our proposed paper. Okay, so now we'll come to the baseline. So this is the data set that we want to reproduce all of the baseline, also our work, in order to make it fair comparison. So it is a data set that is released in the 2023. It contains 15 languages. For example, it is the German, the Spanish, and it is because that it is released in the 2023, it means that it covers a wide range of information, for example, the COVID-19 or the Russian and the Ukraine war. And because it has 15 languages, which means that we want to sample a uniform distribution of the sentences. That's why we have constructed a 600,000 sentences for the training set and approximately 100,000 sentences for the validation set. And in this data set, we want to mention that because it is an unsupervised data set, it means that it has no parallel corpora, and we have to do it by the we remove the soft works and we write and support the work tokens to force the model to reconstruct the corrupted input. And it is some of the baseline that use the unsupervised training, and we also use it with the training set that we mentioned earlier. And here is the multilingual paraphrasing that this work also use the data set that I mentioned earlier with the encoding algorithm to output a lexical difference from the input. And here is the algorithm of the baseline. Okay, so now we'll come to the proposed solution of us. So in this work, we use the multilingual GPT, which has been trained on 61 languages, and it has 1.3 billion parameters, as Khoi mentioned. That's why we use the parameter efficient fine tuning in order to train it more fast. And because it covers a wide range of languages, which means that we can increase the multilingual diversity in the prediction phase. And this is the whole structure of our proposed method. So we will go through the input, we have the embedding, and then we will add the noise here to do the adversarial training, and then we use the parameter efficient fine tuning to force the MGBT predict the paraphrase. And it is the whole algorithm, and the detail of the algorithm can be found in the report. And if we have time, we would talk about it. Okay, so now we'll continue the evaluation data set.
So, for the evaluation data set, we figured out that mostly the paraphrase of the evaluation data set is concerning about the English language only. However, we want to multilingual, and we need to compare our method with our baseline method, and we need to compare them on the same common parameter. That's why we reviewed the first multilingual material and paraphrasing process. So this consists of two types inside this data set. The first one is input only, the second one is input and reference. For the input only, this is easier to find. We follow the Thompson and Post paper to extract the validation set of the six languages inside the UMP 19 version 14, and we assume the languages are English, French, and German. For the input and reference, I think we have one input and another crosstalk, and we extract from some of the data sets such as PODX, stable or open markers, the details of these data sets, how do we reconstruct them. We construct, collect them, can be found detail inside the report. So as you can see here, we have one house of the statistics about the evaluation data set. For example, the number of samples per language inside each type of the data set, as well as the histogram on the number of words per sample inside some of the data sets. This graph can be found inside the report as well. And this is some of the have a table about the number of samples per language inside this data set. And for the metrics that we use to measure, so we use in total six metrics. The first three one is used to measure the lexical aspect of a sentence. Verb score is used to measure the semantic meaning preservation. Verb score and verb score is used to harmonize between the lexical and semantic aspect of the conversation. And this is the main result. We compare the monolingual. For the monolingual, we use only the baseline words of English, and we compare between them with our method. You can see our method have reached the comparable result and nearly outperform all of the baseline. And for more on the open markers and the bias, we have the English subset inside them. For the multilingual settings, we evaluate compared to the Thompson and Post model because it enables the multilingual paraphrasing. And you can see our model can outperform the Thompson and Post with our baseline by a large margin. And we also conduct the human evaluation because metrics are known to be biased and error prone. Therefore, we conduct the human evaluation in order to see more about the advantages and disadvantages of our method. And you can see here we conduct the evaluation for five languages: Chinese, Vietnamese, English, German, and French. For each of these languages, we randomly select two of the samples from the evaluation set. This sample will contain 24 samples and the our model, LAMPAT prediction. And this sample will be graded by five different annotators on a Likert scale from 1 to 5. And this is the result, the average result of our performance. And you can see here all the language agreed by the annotators that it reached some of the performance of 4.0. And this is some of the example of the human evaluation. So we see that the LAMPAT can achieve high power score and more accurate compared to baseline for the given language. If the attainable left cell circuit blurs mean that it can generate a diverse sentence. Due to the effect of the adversarial training, you can steer the model prediction toward a virtual label instead of the real input. And it was trained on a latest version of WMT, therefore some of the latest issue was contained into this model. And it can work well just add on the language system Korean, in which the baseline model cannot work. However, there is still room for improvements. Firstly, we see that for the evaluation dataset, it contains not all the languages around the world, like all the languages around the world of 7,000, but we just cover just a small percentage of them. Therefore, we can say that the language performance cannot be used to be fully multilingual, but in the scope of all the languages inside our capsule project. And the performance of the LAMPAT on some languages, Chinese, Korean, and Chinese was high. However, there is some case where it is degenerated behavior happened. This meant that the repetition of the token happened in output. And we also see that the LAMPAT output sometimes attains a low diversity compared to input. It means that it could be exactly input, especially for input that have a few words, for example, less than 10 words. And the evaluation matrix here are not yet fully all the aspect of the paraphrasing.
So now we'll come to the conclusion. So we have successfully combined the parameter efficient patterning with the adversarial training and the multilingual large language model. And we collect all of them in the unsupervised learning. So throughout the experience, we find that the LAMPAT not only works well on the training languages such as the English, the French, but it can also generalize the unseen languages, which means that we can conclude that it can use the zero-sum cross-lingual paraphrasing. And it is the contribution that we have mentioned earlier. So we have applied the parameter efficient patterning with the large language. And we have integrated the adversarial training. We have also create the first multilingual and multi-domain paraphrasing evaluation data sets. And we have also consolidated the most recent paraphrasing evaluation matrix. And we have also submitted the, our work to the OISBD Symposium 2023. And here are some room for improvements. So we want to increase the number of languages in the training set that we have mentioned. Mm-hmm. We have just conducted 600,000 sentences in the training set, which is quite low. And in the second set, we want to fine-tune the model on the training set that we have collected in the set one. We want to extend the evaluation data set. We want to develop a new method to address the issue of the low resolve languages that Khoi had mentioned. We want to evaluate the model using a new metric, and we want to utilize the human evaluation because this is a way to evaluate the paraphrase very well. And here are the work of us. Here are our plans. And here are some adaptation studies that we, if we have time, we will discuss it. So, yeah. And this is the demo of us. Okay, so we have created a demo here. Okay, so if we input a sentence, we choose the language, and if we output the paraphrase. So, for example, here. And now we go to the second example. So as you can see here, because this is a probabilistic, so it has some error, as you can see. In order to paraphrase it, a sentence, we must retain the information, and when the paraphrase is generated, it missed the information here. So this is an error. The paraphrase, it just contains time. It means this word, for example, and in the second word, that it, the third word where it is the join, and it paraphrase that below. This is not a good paraphrase, for example. However, if we switch to the English, so I have adopted a complex structure of the English, which means it is the inversion sentence. Yeah. So I want to know whether the LAMPAT can perform well on this sentence. So as you can see, it can paraphrase very well of this sentence. Never have I seen anything more beautiful than you, and it paraphrases it. I have never seen someone more beautiful than you, for example. And last example is. Also, inversion sentence. Okay, so it also reconstruct the sentence very well. So I think that's all of the presentation of us. Works well on English in an unsupervised manner. just like us to make it more fair. So it is the English performance.
Okay, you can perform to me that the all of the value here, the accuracy here, is very on the same level, right?
Yes. Yes, on this level, yes.
How about the training?
So we reproduce these two works and this work from scratch to evaluate on this.
Go back. I don't think not you pick up the paper from the paper.
No,
from the other.
No,
you
no.
Have to review the paper.
Yeah.
Why you review the paper? You have to put more step. Your revision is failed.
Yes.
By compare the whole the same with the number in the paper.
I mean reproduce in this case is that we run the pipeline again of the model with their weights.
Yes, that's my phrase. I want to clarify.
Okay.
So these are the methods.
The third row, the number we pick up from the paper or from the experiment.
So we pick up from our experiment.
Yeah.
We train.
That is yeah. You have to pick up from the paper.
Because the original paper has not been
evaluated. Yes, okay, the same, is that right? So that's why you have to read one more experiment to compare the original paper with their with another system. Not that you to evaluate the.
So you mean that we have to use the original data
set? You compare with the review version. Is that the same code, but they evaluate on the same thing.
Yeah.
Now you pick up, you train or draw, you pick up. With the another component B, you see the WMT, that is.
Yeah.
You have to compare with the original number. So we have to add more steps. The first step, you have to compare the pickup number from the paper.
Yeah.
Okay. With the third trio here, with the training, okay, or evaluation with the same lesson that the paper used to present it.
Yes,
if we
have more time,
then
we'll continue that.
Yeah. So we call it need to modify the value of the paper, and then that unreliable.
Yeah.
So that will be easy to outperform.
Yeah.
Right?
So, yeah, I think that's because
the understand why the reviewer had a question.
The original paper hasn't evaluated on this
data set. Okay. Any question more?
Yeah.
No. I'm gonna call the reviewer. No one. Right. So I want to
So I have two questions for you. First, what is this experimental practice behind the proposal? Why do you call this low red adaptation?
So we use the low red adaptation. So this is the Lorentz adaptation.
Why you call it
Lorentz
adaptation?
Okay. So the Lorentz adaptation is the primary efficient fine tuning method to decrease the time to train a large language model because they don't train. They don't fine tune the whole model. They just pick up some part of the model to fine tune it, and it outputs a very comparable result to the method when we fine tune the whole model. So that is what the range
of action. Well, hi, Dr. Professor Thanh come from the mathematics. So that is the thing you have considered on RAM, right? So that why. Can you learn why the relation to the low rate is more clear?
So the pre-trained weight gain, for example, if we have a metric of weight gain, so it uses a decomposition method to decompose metrics to smaller metrics for faster computation. And this smaller matrix here is combined to output the same outputs with the original weight. Yeah.
So we just define a low rate approximate of return weight, right?
Yeah.
Is there any theorem to prove the existence of such a position of matrix? So it is on the form of matrix, right?
Yes, yes. The suggestion of this paper is, and they have their own proof in that, but intuitively they decompose the metric into two smaller metrics with for example, like we can see that it has less row or less column than the original for faster computation.
I suppose it's because for example the SVD position is for all the metrics.
Yeah.
So I wonder if such positions in that paper is this for all of them?
Yes, yes, it is for.
Yes. The second question is how to find the parameter form, and could you please explain why the performance of your proposed models are different in this case and Vietnamese case, even though the score are similar?
So you want us to explain the parameter form?
Yeah.
So about the formula of the parameter,
yeah.
We have attached in the appendix of the report, so you can see the formula.
Okay.
And now we will explain the
yeah.
the intuition. Yeah.
So the parameter score is based on the birth score for semantic meaning, but it also incorporates the lexical based on the normalized lead distance. So normalized lead distance are really dependable on the languages. For thought, we achieve a fairly comparable score between the English and the Vietnamese. However, due to the effect of both the birth score works on English and birth score for Vietnamese, as well as the normalized lead distance are different. Therefore, we have some problem when we run on the model encounter some of the problems when we translate or paraphrase the Vietnamese sentence. But those are from the demo, so we have included more examples for the evaluation of the report. You can see here the model performed well on some sentence in Vietnamese, but some is worse.
Copy.
I have a question about your human evaluation setup. So you said you can classify a lot of sentences called 200 sentence pairs.
For the English and Vietnamese, we ask our friends to do so because we have some knowledge about English and Vietnamese. For the for the German, my friend can give us some friend that studies abroad in German and have some knowledge about German. And especially in our job evaluation dataset, we have an exam and we see that the example inside that one was fairly easy. It's not so difficult for the SVT to rank them. For the French and the Japanese, we have the same scenario as the German one. Yeah, but I have some knowledge about the languages to be able to evaluate.
You also had a method to evaluate the level of this also.
Yes.
Not only easy, we talk from my question, I was in form of formal conclusion. Not easy like that, but have you do something? Not only more research, make sure that that's it will be helpful.
Thank you for your
recommendation. And back to the third slide, please. I think your proposal. Go down. long ago? 1 month. Yeah,
and
yeah. And you do it often. So how do you train more? How do you train your own?
So the whole pipeline is first we have the good sentence, for example, the sentence like I like to eat an apple, for example, and then we will try to remove the stop words from that sentence and we write them simple, the tokens, and then we will try to add some noise here.
Yeah. Maybe not the input will be contained after simple, the word, or token.
No, no, the input is the original sentence, and then we remove the stop word and we support the token.
Yes, so the input is the
software
token.
The software
token. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we go to the
embedding,
and
we ask
the noise
again.
Yes, and we go to the.
You know, you guys know
my
option?
Yes. We have
a option. Then you go to the picture. How to
communicate? So we use the learning adaptation to make the training faster. And then we output the sentence, and we will try to compute the loss, and then we will do the back propagation as
well. Maybe that hopefully you have to compare with your problems by some loss function.
Yeah.
What about loss function? Original.
The loss function is the cross entropy. And yes. So in this case, So because we train in an unsupervised manner to address the lack of the data. For example, in some languages we don't have the supervised data set. So that's why we choose the unsupervised. And then we will try to reconstruct the original input. But as we have mentioned, in some cases it will reconstruct the same as the original sentence. That's why we want to add some noise. We try to use the virtual adversarial training, which means that at least the papers are here. So they try to create a virtual label, and we want to see.
So can you identify the algorithm where is the adversarial part inside?
Okay, so the adversarial part is here. So it is the whole loss of LAMPAT. So it is the reconstruction loss, and it is the virtual loss. So that's why we can construct a very our book has a very diverse lexical choices. Yeah. Because we don't want to reconstruct the same input. We want to add noise and want to make the sentence more diverse.
When you compute the law for the generation step, you need to broaden the degree method for also.
Yeah.
So there are two parts, right?
Yes.
Two parts, no? Right?
Yes.
So if you have to trip that book from the generator.
Yeah.
Go to the original. Do you have any the frozen part? Do you need to frozen?
Oh yes. The frozen part is it chosen by the brain adaptation. And it just fine-tune some parts of the whole model. And when we try to update the gradients based on the back propagation,
okay.
If we use it.
Don't have to survive 32. Okay, around here we have some feasible gate environment, so there are some feasible number. And then all of your our form on again, my question is. You also pick up the number from the original paper, or did you pick up from your experiment?
We pick up from the original paper. Because from the original paper is evaluated on this data set. Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
You done, right?
Go back, please.
Yes, then. What is the wrong? Please log to prove.